Sundays, representing us, family, live streaming around the globe, across space and time. Yes. Indubitably, and good morning, Ahiah, and welcome to all of those in cyberspace watching our live streaming and simultaneous live service here in the Ahiah Center for Spiritual Living in beautiful downtown Pasadena, California, USA, in the heart of the Playhouse Village. That's our name. Yes, we just got renamed over here. Welcome. Glad you were able to come to God's party with us this morning. Today is day 21 of the annual Season for Peace and Nonviolence. And we're here celebrating, and most appropriately, we have the theme is inspiration, and we have an inspiration with us this morning because our very own Dr. Maureen Hoyt is here delivering the wisdom talk. Indeed. We say welcome home, Dr. Maureen. Yes, and most appropriately, she'll be talking on loving what we do. Because our theme this month in February is transformative love. And I got some ideas for you around inspiration, a quotation, an affirmation, and a practice. I kind of like that. The quotation is, the mediocre teacher tells, the good teacher explains, the superior teacher demonstrates, the great teacher inspires. And that's a quote from William Arthur Ward. So that's quite appropriate. We're in for some inspiration this morning. I'm prophesizing. I already know that. Our affirmation is, today I pause to acknowledge all the people who have inspired me, those who have aroused and quickened my creativity and curiosity, my compassion and generosity, my hunger to learn and to grow. Let us remember those folks and just hold them in our hearts right now. And know that we inspire somebody. Somebody somewhere is inspired by us. And finally, the practice. Think of at least two people who exemplify the practice of nonviolence. Acknowledge what it is that you admire about them and what inspires you about them. Practice these behaviors today so that other people may be inspired and share this insight with at least three other people. And you know what I always say is that if you spot it, you got it. What you see in those people is because it's in you. So let us stand on the principles of peace and nonviolence today and go out and inspire some folks to know that peace is possible. That we have seen the Berlin Wall go down. We have seen apartheid in South Africa go down. We have seen civil rights and voting rights passed here. We've seen a black man in the White House. I mean, we've seen a lot of things. So let us hold that vision for the possibility of peace. We could do this. Yes. I'm already inspired. How about you? Yes, indeed. We want to thank everybody who makes the service possible. Chris Glick is our practitioner today. He's musical director. Give him some love. We got Brian Menifee in the corner holding down the rhythm and the percussions. He's keeping the beat alive. Yes, indeed. And then there's Leon Johnson on the bass. Leon. Holding it down. Frederick Southern is hiding out in the sound booth. He's our sound technician today. Frederick, thank you for your loving service. Indeed. And then for all of you who are co-creating this by being here and bringing your heart energy into this space as we broadcast this out to the world. And before we move into the meditation, I just want to let you in on a little insider secret, right? Because a little birdie told me that somebody that we all know and love, somebody I've known all my life, is having a birthday pretty soon. I asked this person, is it true? How old are you? And his answer was, I'm not. Okay, all right. He also told me that he was too young to know when he was born, so the date might not be really the right date. He said, you know, the calendars have changed. There was the Mayan calendar, the Gregorian calendar, all that, right? So, hey, who knows if that's really true or not. But afterwards, a little birdie told me that there's going to be cake in the fellowship hall for this individual who you all know and love. And I'm not mentioning no names, Reverend Mike. No names. And so with that, where am I? What earth, Reverend Mike? What planet is this? Yeah. Let's get God's party started, shall we? Yes, indeed. Gabriel has a wonderful... Oh, no. Music. It is... I'm thankful. I'm grateful. Yes. Words on the screen. I surrender. Amen.
Good morning, Ahiah. Lyrics are up here on the monitor. And you at home, get up close. Put your coffee down first, though.
Sitting over here, there was a minister's trio going on. You know, it was actually kind of cool. So, it's so good to be here with you this morning. And I'm wide awake. I don't have a talk to do because we have a guest speaker. So, you know, I didn't get up at 4:15 in the morning like usual. So bright-eyed, bushy-tailed I am. But having said that, I'm going to ask us to take a nice deep breath in. Just let it all out and let it all go as we take in the modern miracle of Gabriel's meditation video.
There's a hero. If you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of where you are. There's an answer. If you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know melts away, and then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on. And you cast your fear aside, and you know you can survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong. And you finally see the truth that a hero lies in you. Faces were alone. reaches out a hand for you to hold. You can find love if you search within yourself, and the emptiness you feel will disappear. And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry. Cast your fear aside, and you know you can survive. So when you feel like all is gone, look inside your head and be strong, and you finally see the truth that a hero lies in you.
Did you catch the Bambi in there? All these pictures of little kids and then a Bambi. Whoop, and we're going to hear it again. So I'd like to ask Chris to come on up. He's our practitioner of the day. He's going to be doing our reading and our invocation.
Good morning, Ahiah. It's an honor and a pleasure for me to be here today and just being is what I want to talk about today. Not doing, not who I am, not who I want to be, just being. And in being, I know that there's no thing for me to think about. There's nothing for me to judge. There's nothing for me to worry about. Nothing to be happy. Nothing to be sad. And I'm going to read something today. It's from one of the Science of Mind magazines. And it's called Love is the Answer. And in being, just being, all you can do is love. Your body, your mind, your soul, your spirit is incapable of doing anything but that. Now, if you open your mind and start thinking, yeah, you might start judging. But if you stick to just being, love is the answer. God's love is radiant, rejoicing the heart. This is from The Enlightened Heart of Ernest Holmes. Only love knows love, and love knows only love. The Science of Mind, page 418. As spiritual seekers, we love to talk about love. And why shouldn't we? If Ernest Holmes was right when he said that love is the sole impulse for creation. He captured and identified the primal universal energy. Love is the beginnings and endings of all comings and goings. And when we understand this, we can see it for the existential power that it is. Just because we don't always sense the feel-good factor moving through a situation does not mean love is not at work. We often like to say that love is the answer, and it usually is. If we bring the love energy to bear in our prayer work and practices, there are ways that would show up to make straight the means before us to evolve as harmonious actions and satisfactory outcomes. Love is a natural healing presence, and it blesses everyone, and everything is allowed to touch. If love were called into every human interaction, large and small, corporate and casual, public and private, we could be sure we would get many more completions that promise healthy, mutually beneficial attitudes. If love could be looked at as the prime mover that it is, can we imagine the peace producing choices and behaviors that would benefit all? The affirmation, in deepest peace, love, and gratitude, I give great thanks for the gifts of the Spirit that come to me each day. I know that love is always at work, and I let it light everything I do. And this reading about love is just that. We just allow it to be. And in allowing it to be, at this moment, we are all together in the presence of something other than our human selves. We know that presence. We sense it. We feel it. We deeply are part of it. We are it. All of us together, not individually, but as one thing. Yes, we all wear different clothing. We have different colored hair because we're diverse. But so are the petals on every flower that we look at and admire and smell. If we take the petals and separate the petals, they eventually die away. Just like us as humans, as one thing, or one flower. Yes, we die, we become born. We live, but we just be in this presence. For this presence that I know is the presence that is yours and that you know and that you are. And this presence is the only presence. And I just give grateful thanks for this presence in my life, in your life. And I know that the ministers, our guest minister, Dr. Maureen, Reverend Scott, our senior minister, Reverend Michael, our birthday boy. I'm sorry, I had to say that. Because Reverend Mike is like the most wonderful thing. That's all I know. He's just, I mean, what else can I say? Anyway, I'm grateful for these ministers and the musicians and all the people that help and all the people that are here, because, you know, we're an amazing bunch, aren't we? And we are the presence that we talk about. And again, I'm grateful, and I release this word to the Lord, knowing that it is manifest in the smiles I see as I look out. I mean, what can be better than that? So God bless you. And I just say, you say with me, and so it is.
So it is.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris. So I'd like to ask Elizabeth Hangan to come on up. And while she is coming up to get ready to sing for us, I'd like for you guys to just turn to your neighbor and say hi. Give a nice, warm, Ahiah welcome to whoever is around. You don't have to hug, but a nice wave. And a wave to those of you guys online also. So lovely to have you out there on the internet. So, Elizabeth.
Yes.
Take it away.
That's my name.
Yes, it is. Is it your birthday by chance?
Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Reverend Mike and I have the same birthday. We do. I'll be 66. How about you? I'm an Inland Empire baby. I was born in Riverside, so that makes me a Route 66 baby.
So I think our birthday cake is for you, too.
Oh.
Well, do you mind sharing, Rev? Oh, I didn't think so, yeah.
We eat cake. Well, it's good to see everybody. I've been here for a couple of weeks, been working, doing good work, and since today is talking about loving what we do, I'm grateful to be here amongst people that I love doing what I love to do. Mom, if you're watching, good morning. Amazing things with the choice each new day brings, and with every step you take, there's the progress that you make. The reason you live is there in every gift you give. Love your life, love your dreams. You will do amazing things. Amazing, amazing. You will do amazing things. Do amazing things. All the places you will go, and the people you will know. Don't worry about the when, where, or how. You don't need to know that now. You're on the right track. No need to look ahead or back. Just enjoy what this day brings. You will do amazing things. Amazing, amazing. You will do amazing.
is. Here we go.
You don't have to work it out. Just stay in the here and now. Let your mind just rest for a little while. And sometimes deepest answers come when you're out just having fun. So close your eyes, take a breath, and smile. Amazing, amazing, you will do amazing things. Amazing. Do amazing things.
Thank you.
Yes, yes.
To the bridge. Take me to the bridge.
So, if you like Elizabeth, if you think she is amazing, she's here every third Sunday of the month. For this year, we've got her scheduled, I think, all the way through the year, right? Yeah? All right. Okay, so I'd like to go ahead and ask Dr. Maureen to come on up. I find her to be just a wise, loving spirit. I have been so blessed in my own ministry to have her as a mentor, and I'm happy to have her here today.
Amen. Amen. Mm-hmm.
Do you want to do the handheld or the or this one?
This one.
Okay.
Is that good?
Yeah, let's put it maybe like that. Let's see how that looks. Maybe just a little. There we go. Give that a whirl.
Good. All right. You can hear me.
Yes.
Yes. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
You know, Beethoven said, and you know, we get quotes on Facebook all the time, but this one is real. Beethoven said that music is the medium between the spiritual and the sensual. And that song by Michael Gott is absolutely one of the highlights of one of the conferences that we had a while back, and everybody sings it because it has significance for all of us. So today, I want to thank Reverend Scott for inviting me here. He gets to sit in the front row with his hairless head. Yes, that was a surprise, but a nice surprise. I told him he has a nice head. Some people should not be bald, but he should be. So there's something about coming back to Pasadena for me that feels like visiting relatives. You know, the extended spiritual families that we have, we can run into each other somewhere along the way, and there's that instant recognition, as John O'Donohue said, you know, that our two clays separated before birth, and then we come back together in later years, and all of a sudden, there's that instant recognition. So I know that to be true when I come here. And with the theme of transformative love for this month, what I found interesting is that the older I get, you know, I used to think I had all the time in the world for transformation. But the older I get, I feel a sense of urgency about it now. You know, some of us in our early stages of self-discovery, we wanted to be transformed, but we didn't want to be inconvenienced. You know, we wanted to have, I want what you have, and I'm willing to go to, a length or two to get it. Not any length to get it, right? So February was set aside as a tribute to St. Valentine. While we all know the marketing strategy of Hallmark, I rather like the month designated to Black History Month. Some of you may know that my family emigrated to California from Canada in the early 60s, right in the middle of it all. I was a senior in high school in Santa Rosa, California, where fully a third of the school was of African American descent. And interesting for me, coming from Canada in a sort of marshmallow world, if you will, where the only time I ever saw black people was when the Globetrotters came to the town 20 miles away from where I lived. And so for me, it was a fascinating life experience. I didn't grow up with people of color. I grew up with a lot of different creeds, different races, but not, there was a lot of Asian people in the community where I lived. My only connection, I said, was with the Harlem Globetrotters. And so with the integration and the segregation during that time, one of my questions to my classmates was, how could you hate somebody because of the color of their skin? You know, something that you can't do anything about, or how tall a person is, or, you know, what color their hair is. Although mine would be white if I didn't dye it. So there you go. You know, no one could answer the question to my satisfaction. So I made it my business to seek out and read everything I could. Recently, a fellow minister and I were having a conversation. He was raised just outside of Tulsa, Oklahoma. And he said he never heard about Black Wall Street growing up. It wasn't until it came up recently in the news that he said, wait, what are you talking about? You know, I lived less than 10 miles outside of Tulsa and didn't even know about that as a historical perspective from the area in which he was raised. You know, why was that not taught in school? My buddy Jeff Radcliffe, who's from the South and who is a student of religious science, offered this by Ernest Holmes, this quote by Ernest Holmes, "We are never alone, no matter how isolated we may feel from time to time. I believe we are so integrated with life that there is nothing we can do, nor any place we can go where we do not contact the vitality of life in some way." He goes on to say, life or God makes up our being and supplies us with the energy that expresses in and through us as our human form. We cannot simply shake off our biology and our spirituality. They are what we are. They are what we are, our biology and our spirituality. Our biology and our spirituality being what we are, if we are not doing what we love, all the years of our lives may be tainted by doing our work for the money or, God forbid, for the benefits. You know, I had a teacher one time say to me, don't ever do anything for the benefits. You know, for your 401k or for your health insurance, do what you love. Thomas Merton said, if you really want to know me, don't ask me my name or what I do for a living. Ask me what are my dreams and what is keeping me from them. Thomas Merton, Catholic priest, who lived an isolated life by our standards, probably. Some years ago, Barbara DeAngelis, who was famous for being John Gray's sixth or seventh wife, I think, the guy who wrote Men Are From Mars and Women Are From Venus, you remember that book? She spoke at a joint Religious Science International and United Church of Religious Science conference at Asilomar. She was a keynote speaker, and then she did a workshop that afternoon. She spoke to having come to this life experience to practice mastery over relationships. No, duh, seven, right? Okay, she's working on it. But the seventh was her last. She's still married to that man. And that was like at least 20 years ago that I saw her at Asilomar. So someone in the workshop in the afternoon in the Q&A asked her, a significant question. They asked her, why do you feel that this relationship is different from all the others? And without missing a beat, she said, because this time I came to the relationship for what I could bring to it, not for what I could get from it. And so I think that's true in terms of our work situation, for our day-to-day work, that we engage in our work from this perspective as well. You know, it's what we bring to it. Are we there just marking time? Are we, again, God forbid, just working for the benefits? Are we, do we wake up in the morning lamenting Monday through Friday? Oh, another day, another dollar. You know, oh gosh, I have to go to work today. Not I get to go to work today. There are a lot of people, at least in the last couple of years, who aren't working and don't have jobs and living hand to mouth. So Marcia Sinatar, in her books, Do What You Love and the Money Will Follow, and the second book, To Build the Life You Want, Create the Work You Love, she said, do what you love and the money will follow. The same name as the book. And some of you, just segueing for a little bit here, some of you may know about Les Paul. I'm sure you do. Famous, famous guitarist. 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, and even 80s. He, in 1948, Les Paul was in a terrible, terrible car accident, near fatal car accident, actually, and none of the doctors were able to fix his arm fully. So he had them fuse the bones of his elbow in a 90-degree angle so he could still play the guitar. Now that's dedication to work and doing what you love. You know, there are a bazillion stories like this out there, but they serve to show us an example of what that means, doing what you love. Whatever the scenario, we need for love and belonging can be so strong that it blinds us to our most valuable talents and qualities. We then live a life of pretense and self-negation. Of course, our working life will suffer also, because it is but a part of our life as a whole. Marcia Sinatar said that, I think, in the first book. No one here lives a life of pretense and self-negation, because we're all works in progress. We're masterpieces, but we are still works in progress. There's that one last little dab of paint to put on the masterpiece, you know, one more little tiny part of myself that I want to fix or change. But the reality is, the song was right. I love myself the way I am. There's nothing I need to change. I'll always be the perfect me. There's nothing to rearrange. I mean, if we could really feel that internally and internalize it and make it our mantra, life would be so much easier and so much better for all of those people who love us and watch us go through our miseries periodically, right? Right? You know, no one here, like I said, we're all on the road of self-discovery and self-actualization. We are in the science of mind because we're here to contribute something of value, not only to ourselves, but to everybody we see. We believe, as Ernest Holmes and Jesus taught, that I come that they might have life and have it more abundantly. That is the truth. I might be taking poetic license here, but I feel as though that means for us to do the work and contribute to the greater good in such a way that we're eager to jump out of bed each day to see what great and wonderful things are about to show up for us. I can't sort of fancy myself jumping out of bed, but, you know, it's a figure of speech, let's say. So do y'all know who Marion Croak is? You're going to see the picture on the screen, and the people on the live stream may not see the picture because it's sort of an afterthought to put it up. But if you see this face, look at that sweet face. I learned about who she is from the Women on the View on the first Sunday of Black History Month. And I got so excited to meet her, I went and studied everything I could find about her on the internet. What did we ever do before the internet, right? What did we ever do? Marion Rogers Croak is the Vice President of Engineering at Google. She was previously the Senior Vice President of Research and Development at AT&T. She holds more than 200 patents. She was inducted into the Women in Technology International Hall of Fame in 2013. While at AT&T, Croak and her team contemplated the potential of digital communications. She worked on advancing voice over internet protocol, VOIP. You'll see that sometimes in your travels on the internet. Converting voice data into digital signals that can be easily transmitted over the internet rather than using traditional phone lines. None of that makes any sense to me whatsoever, but it may to some of you who are sitting here today. Her work has furthered the capabilities of audio and video conferencing. Croak joined Google in 2014 as Vice President of the Engineering Group. At Google, she's responsible for expanding the internet, of what the internet is capable of doing around the world, and increasing access to the internet in the developing world. She did all kinds of other stuff. But at the end, Croak also works on racial justice efforts at Google and continues her goal of encouraging women and young girls in engineering. Engineering for so many years has largely been a male-dominated world. And here she is making herself known. If you're a novel reader and you haven't read Lessons in Chemistry and you might have grown up in the 50s and the 60s, read that book. It's hysterical on so many levels. It's a novel, but it has to do with, well, I'm not even going to tell you what it has to do with. Take my word for it. Go get the book and read it. You'll laugh out loud in places, and you'll need 3 Kleenexes in other places. But it is about a woman's struggle in the late 50s and 60s trying to enter the world of science when women were relegated to being secretaries or nurses or whatever. So she's a pioneer in an industry made up of mostly men, as I said. She is clearly a person who jumps out of bed each day wondering what amazing new ideas are going to spring forth. We all have the capacity to make a difference. Do we understand that? It could be just a fleeting moment with somebody. It could be a lifetime experience with somebody. Every time I log on to the internet, I'll think of her and offer a moment of gratitude for her excellence in inventing and implementing the technologies that she has been so creative with. This is living life more abundantly and doing what she loves. Some of us may be going to that sort of self-flagellation place where we don't see ourselves as a Marion Croak. We don't see ourselves as a Les Paul or a Steve Jobs or any of those kinds of people. But here's the interesting part. You know, we're not maybe going to find the cure for cancer. We're not going to be an award-winning composer necessarily. But we might have given birth to a child who is or does. We may know someone who might. We may have a family member who might be creative in that kind of area. Don't let our whatever perceived limitations we think we might have stop us from being more than we can be. When we do what we love, we are change makers. You know, when Reverend Scott gets a phone call from somebody who says that the spiritual mind treatment that he did for that person changed their lives, that is being a change maker. He is doing what he loves. When I see the lights come on, with the students in my classes, for perhaps even just one student who has been stuck in her old, no longer useful thinking, I am encouraged to continue facilitating such classes because I love what I'm doing. And I see that it's making a difference in somebody else's life. When the boss calls us into his office and tells us our performance as part of the publicity team has made a difference and there's a bonus involved, we know we've made a difference. That would be my son, by the way. Keeping it in the family. You know, last Sunday, Reverend Scott presented a quote by Ernest Holmes. I watched him. I'm a troll, I guess, is what they call me. But sometimes if I don't go to church on Sunday, I'll spend the whole day watching sermons. And, you know, by the end of the day, there's nothing I can't do. I mean, I'm so uplifted, I'm walking a foot off the floor, which is no easy task, I might tell you. He said, Scott said, Ernest Holmes said, love heals, forgives, and makes whole. We have within us a power that is greater than anything we shall ever contact in the outer, a power that can overcome every obstacle in our life and set us safe, satisfied and at peace, healed and prosperous, in a new light and in a new life. You know, if I could have that tattooed on my forehead so every time I look in the mirror I see that, you know, it's never too late to have a happy childhood. I know there must be a few Pisces people here because I'm going to have a birthday coming up in just less than a month. And I never thought I'd get to be that age. You thought I was going to tell you. But I am turning 79, which is a pivotal age for me because I have now outlived my mother by a whole entire year. So there's significance there. So going back to the beginning of this talk and to move forward as we go throughout the rest of our day, I have two questions. What are your dreams? And what is keeping you from them? If you're not doing what you love, find something more interesting to think about. If you're not speaking words of love, find something more interesting to think about. If you're not loving yourself with your positive self-talk, find something more interesting to think about. And as the old saying goes, don't believe everything you think. We are here to have life and have it more abundantly. And as Emma Curtis Hopkins so beautifully admonished, now go out there and act like it. Emma, she was a tough cookie, wasn't she? Knowing with God, all things are possible. So I'm happy to be here today. I'm glad to visit with you. And I'll stick around for a little bit afterwards. I was told I have a Board of Trustees meeting at Granada Hills today, so I have to kind of wend my way back there, so I won't stay too long. But thank you all for being here today, and thank you again, Reverend Scott, for having me here.
Oh, so let's go ahead and use this time to anchor in a few ideas, a few thoughts into our own knowingness. And so I invite you to come along with me on a small prayer. Knowing absolutely that this transformative love that we are talking about this month of February, this transformative love that Spirit is, that God is the life, the power, the presence that moves through everything. This life that Spirit is that just says yes. This life that Spirit is that lifts us higher. This life that Spirit is that is the backbone of everything that we see and that we touch. I know it is love. I know it is peace. I know it is joy. I know it is all the good in the universe. And as that's the truth of Spirit, it's the truth of me, it's the truth of you, it's the truth of those of you online. This life that God is moving through us and as us, and so that love, that transformative love that God is moving through us and having its way with us. It's transforming us, it's creating inside of us and through us and as us into our lives and beyond. All that we need, all that we require, all that we desire, all that we are, it moves us just a little bit. Just a little bit more towards love. Just a little bit more towards the peace that we intrinsically are. Just a little bit more towards this life that we hold as our dream. This life that is more and more and more in alignment with what Spirit is. And so I know that the blessings that God is pours out onto us and over us and through us and moves into our lives with beauty and with ease and with grace. And for knowing that, I just give thanks. And I release this prayer to the law, knowing that it's already fulfilled in the mind that God is. And I say, life and God are good and very good. And together we say, and so it is. Amen and amen. And so now is the time for our conscious contributions. If you are here inside the sanctuary with us today, there are offering envelopes that you can put your offering in. And we have, looks like, Sandra and Dorothy, who are our ushers today, are bringing up our plates that you can put the offering into. If you are online, there are three ways for you to give. There is ahiah.com/donate, and you can give through Breeze, or you can give through GiveButter if you want to give through PayPal or through Venmo. There is also always the text to give option, which is just text the word give to 616-229-2225, and then follow the directions from there. Or you can always send a little love note in with your check to Ahiah at the address showing on your screen. I love the little love notes that you guys send, so thank you for those. And so I've got the blessing up here on our screen. Let's go ahead and read that together. This gift I give is God in action. I send it forth with joy, confidence, and ease. I am blessed by the law of giving and receiving, as I now share my gift with life. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over. And so it is. Amen and amen. Thank you, family. So I'd like to go ahead and ask Elizabeth to come up. She's going to share another song with us.
So this is a song about building things. When it's time for a change, you want to build something and get yourself out someplace else. I'm tired of that same old words, same old lines, same old tricks, same old rhymes. Days, precious days, rolling in and out like waves. Got boards to bend, planks to nail, I got charts to make, I got seas to sail. I'm gonna build me a boat with these two hands. It'll be a fair turf for a noble plan. Let the chips fall where they will, 'cause I got boats to build. Sails are like wings, the wind can make them sail. sing songs of life, songs of hope, songs to keep your dreams afloat. Shores, distant shores, that's where I'm headed for. The stars to guide my way, sail into the light of day. I'm gonna build me a boat with these two hands, be a fair curve from a noble plan. So let the chips fall where they may, 'cause I got boats to build. From a noble plan, let the chips fall where they will, 'cause I got boats to build. 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 Make mine a yacht. Thank you. Big old yacht.
All right. Well, let's see. You know, we finished up just a little bit early. If somebody could go run and get our kids, that would be wonderful.
I told them to come over.
Oh, Frederick's already got them. All right. Well, they'll be here in just a few minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and tell us a few other things then. First of all, we've had some problems for those of you guys online especially. We've had some issues with Facebook lately. Yeah. It's real laggy and doing all sorts of things, and there's nothing we can do about Facebook. So what we suggest is that you go to YouTube instead. YouTube is a service that was built for video and live streaming. Facebook kind of just slapped it on at the, you know, after they'd been around for a while. So YouTube's a better service for this. So you can always find it very, very, very easily. This is a picture showing up on our screen here of our website, and you can see where there's a little oval there around the red button that says live stream. Just hit that, and it'll take you to a page that has YouTube right sitting right there in front of you. So, and if you want to try Facebook, it's got a button for Facebook too, so you can, you know, make all your choices. So just go ahead and give that a whirl. I want to remind you that not only do we have birthday cake today, but at 1 o'clock, after the birthday cake and everything is over, we will have fun with our Wisdom of the Enneagram class. Now, this is our third workshop. So in the first two workshops, we really got people comfortable on which of the nine types you are. Now, if you already know which type you are, then come on down. You're welcome to join. But if you're not quite sure, I don't think you would get anything out of this yet. So let's, but love to see you. And for those of you who have been in the workshop before, you still got a little bit of time to get out of your PJs. I'm talking to you out there online. Get out of your PJs and come on down. We're going to have a lot of fun. And so also we have Reverend Mike. Now, Reverend Mike's workshop is coming up sometime soon. We have April 2nd here on the slide, but the reality is that that date is been overtaken by our annual meeting. So so we're going to switch out with that, but we'll give you some ideas around that. We have another workshop with Reverend Carol Lotz that's coming up in March. So we'll get you all informed on that one, and then Reverend Mike will be the next one after that sometime. Yeah, absolutely.
Hi, family. Hey, just want to put a little plug in for opening the Hacker's Toolkit and the reason why I'm doing this. So scams on Facebook, on social media, are at an epidemic high. The FBI has reported that last year, $34 billion was taken out of seniors' retirement money, right, due to scams. Just last night, we got yet another puppy scam. Have you seen those cute little Yorkie puppies on Facebook, right? They're a scam. Somebody called me again. They were just about to go pay the money to get them a cute little Yorkie and wanted to know, did we want one too? Because they had two, and we were able to save them. So you definitely want to come to this workshop, to bring your family, bring your kids, because some of these scams are on Call of Duty. They're on Roblox, the games that the kids are playing, right? I know because I play them too. But the scams are out there, and they're stealing accounts, taking over the kids' accounts, and then getting to the parents through the kids' account that's been taken over. So come on out. It's going to be really, really interesting sometime in April.
All right. Thank you, Reverend Mike. So I see a whole bunch of kids out here. Let me just, right before I send it over to them, remind you that we are getting ready for our annual meeting. The board this last Wednesday decided that the annual meeting's date is April 2nd. So we have two of our board members that are leaving. That is Deborah and Myrna. And so Myrna's our board president. Deborah's our treasurer. We are looking for people who would like to serve. And so the nominating committee is Ruby Qualsgrave, Frederick Southern, who's in the booth over here. Ruby is right back there. Myself, as well as Myrna and Deborah, are all on the board, are all on the nominating committee. We would love to chat with you if you've been a member for at least a year. That's the one caveat. So, love to talk to you. So let's go see what our kids have been up to today. We got a whole passel of them.
Good morning. So this morning, Alejandra is going to start and tell you what we did today.
What we learned is that you're unique and kind, but even if others make fun of you, you just be more you.
That's right.
Beautifully said. Thank you. We spent some time talking about our strengths, and Dry's going to share what some of her strengths are.
I'm double jointed, and some people are nervous of the way my arm moves.
Why are they
nervous about it? Because it moves in a rapid way.
But they just don't understand it, right?
They're not double jointed, they're jealous.
We also made some buttons to remind us of what our strengths are or how special we are, and we're going to share some of those that we made for all of you.
Oh, cool.
Ready?
Yes.
Put your hands out. All right, go ahead, you guys. And that's it from us. Thank you.
Hello. In the teen room, we also talked about strengths and self-love. We talked about how we are divine creations from God, and we were made perfectly. And once you start to... not love ourselves for the way we were created, we start to fight with ourselves, and it starts to be a detriment on the way you live life. And so you have to remember that you're made in the image of God, which is perfect. And so there's no reason to turn on yourself. And so we talked about all our strengths to remind us. We made a page so we can visually see it, if that helps us. And so that's what we talked about today. Thank you, guys.
Perfect. Perfect. Thank you, Malachi. So, you know, how many of you guys received a little love note from our kids? Yeah? Yeah? Yeah. Your mom got it, yeah. I've been hearing from people how much they love those. Yeah. So thank you guys for making those for the folks that we gave them to. Yeah, absolutely. All right, so it is time for us to do our benediction. I want to remind you that in this corner of the fellowship hall, we're going to be doing some live streaming over there. So those of you who are on Zoom, if you want to stay on Zoom, then you can maybe even chat a little bit with Reverend Mike, whose not birthday is around this time, or Elizabeth, whose birthday definitely is Tuesday. Or just say hi to the people that are coming by. So just stay on Zoom. If you are watching on YouTube or something, go to our usual Zoom channel and we'll catch you there. So let's go ahead and, I want to remind you about our ministry of prayer. You can always go to ahiah.com/meet-our-practitioners to get contact information for our practitioners. And who are our practitioners who are here today? I know there's myself, and there's Chris, and Reverend Mike. I saw Myrna in the back, and Jackie was here, too. So we would love to pray with you if there's anything on your heart that you would like some prayer around. You can also listen to Dial a Prayer. It's on our website and on our TV, or on our, not a TV, telephone. I wish we had a TV station. Wouldn't that be cool? So let's go ahead and do the benediction together. It's on our screen. Let's read it together. Something wonderful is happening through me right now. It is this thing called life. Life is in my mind. Life is in my body. Life is in all of my affairs. I accept it. I am it. And I share it. Just the way it appears, and just the way it appears not. Thank you, life. Amen and amen. So I love you guys. I would love to see you over there in the fellowship hall. And if I don't see you, I will see you next week, either here or on our live stream. Thank you. Until then. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye.